This is Andrew Qualley Stocks. Today is Thursday, December 16th, 2010. Today we're taking a look at Pacific Capital Bancorp. This is a NASDAQ Global Select stock trading their ticker PCBC. Kind of a typical financial play. Just had a real tough time this year. Up here over $5. Slide all the way back down now throughout the course of the year to just over 25 cents. You closed at 30 cents yesterday. Almost 14 million shares traded. There's plenty of liquidity. The volume increasing through here is one of the things that caught my eye. I'm just wondering if this is trying to catch a bottom and then try and make up some of this ground that it's lost recently. Nice move right through here. Nice uptrend in the MACD. Overall, still seeing a positive divergence with the MACD. PPO, kind of a double bottom sort of look to it. Already got the bullish cross with both the PPO and MACD. Histograms trending over zero and slightly increasing. ADX kind of middle of the road. Trend definitely losing some strength, so we're going to hope this is going to try and flatline and curl. Positive and negative DI is in good position. See, we've got the 14 and 21 MFIs over top of 50 at this point. The 7 making a sharp turn coming back up. So I'm wondering if it's going to establish some sort of trend over top of 50, which is one thing that we always look for. Slightest uptrend in the accumulation distribution. Looks like it's turning, going to head back north. Ultimately going to look more down the road and look for some higher highs to come in through this area. Shaky money flow trending right around zero right now, showing that buying pressure is about equal to selling pressure. Overall, we're still seeing a general uptrend in the shaky money flow. CCI has made its way back through negative 100, establishing a pretty nice uptrend. I'd look for that break of zero at this point. The full stow looks like it's going to try and turn back down and not hold over 50. We want to see it. See how it's been trading down in here, relatively bearish. We want to see it get over 50 and try and establish a trend up there. So I want to pay attention to this today and see what that full stow line does. And see if it's going to be able to hold over 50 or not. We just got to cross with the tricks. But the signal line's even trying to flatline at this point. Pretty low down at negative 3, a long ways to go to get back to zero, but holding another bottom. And we'll be looking for that long-term trend line to try and fall. Similar to the full stow, once again, one thing we always reference, trading down below 50. You can see how difficult that area can be to break through. Chart couldn't really get any momentum, even with this move. That's the only time we got the longer-term RSIs over top of 50. And of course, with this gap down, it fell right back below, and since then, back in August, haven't been able to make their way back over 50. So we're going to keep an eye on those, see if we can get these longer terms, the red and gold lines, 14 and 21, see if they want to penetrate 50 or not. Kind of a small, if I was zoomed in, this would be a little bit more clear. Kind of a small little wedge pattern going on right here. We're going to look for that to be broken. I definitely want to see this hold right through that 26 area as a bottom support. I want to see it continue to make a higher low. I don't want to see it dip all the way back down to 22. So even if it wants to dip from here, which I won't be ecstatic with because I don't want to see it break the bottom side of this trend line, but I would still consider it a possible play if it could hold over 26 and try and continue uptrend. From just a general PPS resistance, not only am I going to be looking for that trend line to be broken, then I'm going to want to see it get up into here and challenge this resistance at 36 cents. You can see it came up and touched it a couple weeks ago. It was a little bit of a support level right through here back in early November. That's a key point I want to see it take out. Pretty decent gains from a percentage standpoint from 30 cents all the way up to 36 cents. So you're talking 20% just to make it to that. You can see the short-term moving averages are trying to curl up underneath it. The 20-day moving average middle Bollinger Band is coming into play now. It looks like it's trying to even itself out and trying to become a more neutral of a stock play at this point. Not really bullish, not really bearish. And some of the indicators are giving hints that it might try and go bullish. And with this volume increasing regularly over this last month, that might be saying that investors are looking at this as a buying opportunity for PCBC. So I want to keep a close eye on this. It's a bank stock, so they can be very difficult sometimes. They haven't been cooperating in a lot of senses, just not getting much love. But the chart itself is looking pretty nice. So I'm going to keep my eye on it and see what this does here in the near future. As always, this is merely my interpretation of the PCBC chart. This is Andy with Qualley Stocks. Thank you for watching and trade smart.